So, recombinase polymerase amplification is an isothermal amplification technique, and in traditional PCR you use different temperatures to achieve separation of strands, annealing of primers, and amplification. Here, all of this is done by proteins. So a recombinase forces the primers into the double strand, then single strand binding protein prevents displacement of the primer, and a strand displacing polymerase synthesizes a new strand. The amplified product can then be detected by a fluorescence probe. The advantages, all of this happens at the same time and at one temperature, so it's very fast, there's no temperature cycling. You get a result in less than 30 minutes. These assays are relatively easy to design and optimize. It can be multiplexed against different targets. It's fully field deployable and robust and reliable. All you need beside your consumables is one of those isothermal amplification machines, a power source, and if you want to be fancy and look at your results right away, a laptop. Candidatus Liberibacter solanacearum is a phloem-limited non-culturable alpha proteobacterium, so a little bit hard to handle. It infects solanaceous plants like potatoes and tomatoes, and it's a causal agent of zebra chip disease in potato. It's vectored by this insect, the tomato potato psyllid, and in New Zealand it causes about $25 million in damages every year. In Australia, you have the vector but not the pathogen yet, but the potential damage will be easily $100 million per year in Australia if CLSO ever arrives here. We used whole genome sequencing to identify unique regions of CLSO, and then you use your target and you design an initial set of two primers and a probe, and if that works, you design a whole bunch of additional primers to be tested in all combinations to find an optimal assay. As you can see here, different primer combinations lead to a vast variety of performances with the original set somewhere in the middle. And overall, this assay has a runtime of 12 minutes. It has a detection limit of less of 1,000 copies of the target sequence, which is about 200 etograms of DNA. It can identify 93.3% of our field collected CLSO positive samples. It's highly specific for CLSO. We never observed any false positives. You can use it on plant material or insects collected in the field, and the isothermal amplification machines allow you to be set up for a traffic light result that says yes, no, or try again. So it can be performed after minimal training in situ without any molecular knowledge. Thank you.